Not a good start. Not a good start. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh no! Damn it!
Yeah, alright! Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. money.
Boop boop.
Thank you. Thank you. All right. Thank you. Thank you. Boogie. Boogie boogie boogie. boogie 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 boogie
Meep, meep. Thank you. Got it. Boogie.
Last stage. I hope I can do it. Way up there. There it is. Found it. There we go. That's incredible. I beat it. I'm so happy. This is a tough game, man. The randomizer is what makes the game hard. Once the presents randomize and you don't know what you have, basically they reset. In the beginning, you open up the present and you figure out what's in them. But if you open up a randomizing present, it's going to reset them and you're not going to know what's in them. And that makes it hard because you could literally get, like, you know, presents that can kill you. And that's the hardest part about the game. Literally that part. If it was just straightforward and you didn't have any randomizer presents, then it wouldn't be that hard. But because you have randomizers, like right around like level 10, like all the stuff that you work for to unlock, it goes away. And it makes it a lot harder. So yeah, like my previous playthrough, I came close. I had 2 pieces left with Toe Jam and I died. And this time, what I did was I was a lot more selective, maybe about middle of the game, as far as, you know, which presents I opened. In the beginning, I opened up a bunch of them. I didn't care. But towards the middle of the game, I really stopped and I was trying to find a carrot man, but I couldn't really find them. So I just played it safe and I ended up getting a randomizer. I think I got it twice, but I still was able to beat the game. I think that's a first for me. Like, I normally, when I get a randomizer, it doesn't fare well for me. But this time, I was able to beat the game. And this is like the prequel to Part 2, which is Panic in Funkatron, which I have never played, ever. This is about my 3rd or 4th time I beat this game. I think I beat it like twice now with Earl and once with Toe Jam. Something like that. For some reason, I struggle less with Earl. I don't know why that is. I just struggle less with him. I know that he takes more damage, like overall throughout the game. He takes more damage and he doesn't walk too slow. He has that, like, that swag, that little bit of a hump. You know, depending on who you play with, if you play with Earl, you have to go up to meet you with your family. But if you play with Toe Jam, what took you so long? You have to go down here, and then that's the ending of the game. Yeah, this is a really good classic Sega Genesis game, which I really, really adore. And yeah, it took me about 2 hours and 30 minutes to beat it. Great game, man. Great, great game. And for the most part, there was no commentary. I was just really trying to focus on the game. But yeah, man. Finally beat it. Great game. And this is me, Omiglio, signing off.